Hi folks, Artist Mac here. Dealing with an issue with the Fiero, the clutch. So, let me show you what's going on. I was driving along the other day, just, you know, my usual runs. And I was at a stoplight, and of course you gotta... making a left turn, you know, waiting for the other traffic to go by. And as I turned, I noticed that the clutch pedal suddenly, it felt like it had just hit a brick. I mean, it stopped far up from where it normally stops. And right after that, I could not go into gear. You know, I would have been stranded otherwise. What I ended up having to do, every time I would stop, the car would die. You know, even when it was in gear. And what I had to do was just make sure it was in gear, first gear. And I would start it up, and as old-time manual cars used to do, it would start and it would lurch forward. And that way I was at least able to get home. I mean, this would happen every time I would stop. Fortunately, I didn't have to stop too often. But, well, I got it in the garage and started looking online because I had never had any trouble with this clutch. I mean, we're talking 1984. So, I had never had any experience with this before. So, I started reading up and people started talking about brake fluid weeping into the interior, and I thought, oh, that couldn't be me. Well, I'll show you, and I'll show you what's happening when I press down the clutch pedal. Yeah, here's the clutch pedal. All right. This whole assembly right here. And under here, yeah, this is the rod that goes to the master cylinder, and I can see, yeah, there we go. Can you see that bit of wetness there? So yeah, I think something's wrong with the master cylinder. Great. It's exactly the way everybody's described it. So, I'm gonna have to get that done. Fun, fun, fun.
Oh, I forgot to add. When I checked the master cylinder, you know, took the cap off and looked in there, the fluid was at the add mark, you know, and I always made sure that it was, you know, at full. So before I start pouring any brake fluid in there and making things worse, I thought I better check with you guys and see what the best course of action is, because I'm sure the Fiero community has had some experience with this. Now, from what I've read so far, depending on how bad this is, my options are either bleeding the clutch system or replacing both the master cylinder and the slave cylinder. I mean, they have been on there since, well, 1984, so it's probably best to just get the whole thing done. The only complication might be trying to do it around that coolant hose, because it's right over the slave cylinder, so trying to get that out is going to be a bear. I'm going to try doing it myself. If not, I may just have to take it to Dave Armstrong and eat ramen noodles for the next 6 months. Okay, if you have any ideas, write me in the comments section. Right now, I'm going to go in and unfreeze my fingers. After 2 days of 60-degree weather, suddenly we had Noah's Ark rain. And now it's somewhere in the low 30s. This is Artist Mac signing off.